एक बच्चा आ गया और नहीं दो आ गए, छह आ गए, देख तो रहा है बच्चा आते जा रहा है। अभी आप पे कर रहे हैं बात?
हाँ अभी थोड़ा देर मेरे पे कर दो, मैं बात करता रहा हूँ। गुड मॉर्निंग बच्चों, आई एम अटल मिश्रा फॉर यू पीपल, योर केमिस्ट्री टीचर इज हियर एंड प्लीज दिस इज द 11th क्लास, केमिस्ट्री 11th क्लास एंड वी आर डिस्कसिंग द फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ आवर बुक। And the first chapter is the basic concept in chemistry. Before going for today's topic, I would like to just introduce you again. What is the importance of this first chapter in our chemistry? From 9th class, 10th class, you have studied basics. Even I can say the very, very small portion of the chemistry in very nascent form, and the concept taken from that books, that chapters, here we are just revising. In the last class some student asking whether it is 10th class or 11th class, so let me clear you that I am taking the concepts of 10th class and 9th class which will be used in 11th class. So that is very important that we are just making revision from previous classes, and here the name of chapter is Basic Concept in Chemistry. The chapter itself speaks that it is basic concept. So you have to study the basic terminology used in chemistry, and we will use throughout our life, I can say. Being a student of chemistry, I am using it continuously, and many of you may be follow chemistry in your life. Otherwise, up to 10th class, 12th class, you have to follow these terms very frequently without keeping the meaning of these terms in your mind. That will become the very integral part of your study. So friends, I started this chapter by using the basic terms. Basic terms like matter, atom, molecules, compounds, mixture, these terms you must know, and you are knowing it since you have studied all these terms in your junior classes, I can say 9th and 10th. But these are going to become very, very important terms in our future studies. That's why we are taking it continuously, and I am talking it continuously. Matter, again, quickly I would like to revise. Matter is anything which occupies space, having mass, and can be sensed by any of the five sensory organs. The smallest particle of matter is the atom, and you know the atom is further made up of electron, proton, and neutron. You will see all these fundamental particles of atom in the second chapter, that is structure of atom. But today I have to study only atom. Atoms combines together to form molecules. Like hydrogen molecule, two atom of hydrogen atom, two atom of hydrogen, that is H into H, combines together to form H2. But when more than two types of atom combine, they will form compounds like hydrogen and oxygen combined together to form water. And when you are mixing different material together, they will form mixture. Their composition is definite. We are getting the mixture in our nature, like in the case of petroleum product. Variety of things we are getting from nature in the form of mixture. Those mixture can be homogeneous and heterogeneous. Like you can take example of air. Air is the homogeneous mixture since it contains nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide as a gas. But dust, smoke, they are heterogeneous because they contains solid particles. So when air is mixed with some solid particle, then it become heterogeneous mixture. In the milk you are adding water, then it will form another mixture. Can you tell me which type of mixture is water and milk? Yes, please. I am looking for your answer. Okay. Anyone? Water and
homogeneous.
Homogeneous. Someone is saying homogeneous. Very good. Other one? So of course it is homogeneous, since the composition in every part of the solution or mixture is same. Similarly, when you add some drop of ink to water, this will form homogeneous mixture. So when the every component of mixture is same, then you can say homogeneous. In general, I am saying the solid to solid is homogeneous, liquid to liquid homogeneous, gas to gas homogeneous. But solid in gas, it will become heterogeneous mixture. So that is very important things which you have to study in day by day as we will progress in our chemistry. Another term that is very important for study of chemistry is the element. Can you define what is element? So element is the purest form of the matter or substance which is made up of same type of atoms. Like I am writing one of the element sodium, then I can see the entire sodium element is made up of sodium atom which have 2, 8 and 1, that is 11 electron, 11 proton and 12 neutron. So when you are saying element sodium, then you have to picturize the concept that every element have only one type of atoms and its isotope as well. Similarly, when element combine together, they will form molecules or compounds. To govern the combination, we have studied the four different laws like conservation of mass, definite proportion, multiple proportion and gaseous combination. All these I have discussed in earlier classes, but today I am reminding you people. Conservation of mass says that in any chemical reaction the mass of reactant is always equal to the mass of product. In any chemical reaction, the mass of reactant is always equal to the mass of product. Here you can see carbon plus oxygen combines 12 gram of carbon and 32 gram of oxygen. It will give you 12 plus 32, that is 44 gram of carbon dioxide. So any chemical reaction, this law is hold correct even today without any exception. So the chemical reaction follow this law very ritually. Right? So you have to keep this law in your mind whenever you are dealing chemical reaction. Whenever you are dealing with the chemical reaction, you have to keep it in mind that the mass of reactant is always equal to the mass of product. Every reaction holds this law accurately, correct. Next is definite proportion. When I am saying definite proportion, so friend, suppose I am taking water. Water have two element, hydrogen and oxygen. Again, this is from your 9th class. And here 2 gram of hydrogen combines with 16 gram of oxygen. So you can see hydrogen to oxygen ratio 2:16, that is 1:8. So friend, in any part of the universe, not the world, whenever you see the water, you will always find the ratio of hydrogen to oxygen is 1:8. Either you are getting water from natural resources, even in your chemical reactions, any way, any point, at any point of the time, when you will get water, the ratio of mass 1:8. Similarly, in case of carbon dioxide, carbon to oxygen fix. Similarly, in case of glucose, carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, they always combines in the definite proportion. That means their composition remains constant. Next one is multiple proportion. That is very important. Multiple proportion. I have 1 rupee. I am just investing this into market. After 10 days, my 1 rupee, the value of my 1 rupee become 10 rupees. That means my money has been multiplied. Similarly, when two elements like hydrogen and oxygen, they combine and form more than at least two compound or more than two compound, like in case here you can say water and H2O2. So what you are observing, you are observing the mass of hydrogen is 2 gram, but mass of oxygen 16 gram and 32 gram. So what this law state? This law state that when the fixed mass of an element, when the fixed mass of an element combines with variable masses of other element, when the fixed mass of an element combines with the variable masses of other element, these variable masses are in the simple ratio. These variable masses are in the simple ratio. What can I conclude? When hydrogen and oxygen combine together to form water and hydrogen peroxide, the fixed mass of hydrogen combines with oxygen into the ratio of mass of 1:2. So this is the multiple proportion, because the same mass of hydrogen multiplied the different mass of oxygen. Is it that clear? Is it that clear, friends? Yes, very good. Very good. So, friend, this is the law of multiple proportion, where you can see the basic point of the multiple proportion is that there must be two elements. They combine together to form at least two or more than two compounds. Then the fixed mass of an element combines with variable mass of other element, and these variable masses are in the simple ratio. Like I am taking another example. Nitrogen and oxygen combines together. Nitrogen and oxygen combines together to form 5 compound: N2O, NO, N2O3, NO2, N2O5. These are the 5 oxide formed by nitrogen. Nitrogen monoxide, dioxide, trioxide, tetraoxide and pentoxide. Here you can fix the mass of nitrogen. Here the mass of nitrogen is 28, but here it is 14. Again 28, but 14. Again 28, but 14. So I can make it into 28. So for 28 gram of nitrogen, I am observing the mass of oxygen 16. Again multiply it by 2. 28, then mass become 32. Again 28. Again multiply it by 2, 28, again 28. So there is fixed mass. And what you can see, here it is 16, here it is 32, here it is 48, here it is 2, 2 is 4, 64, and 16, 5 is 80. This is the fixed mass and this is the variable mass. The fixed mass is what? You can say fixed, variable mass. What is the ratio of variable masses? You can see like this. 1:2, 2:3, 4:5. That is how you can say multiple proportion. The fixed mass of nitrogen combines with variable masses of oxygen and the variable masses of oxygen is 1:2:3:4:5 in case of 5 oxides of nitrogen. Is it that clear? Is it that clear? Okay, friends. You must remember I am teaching 11th class chemistry and myself is Atul Mishra. Who are the joining the class late? Please must clear in your mind this is the 11th class. Another law is the gaseous combination. Law of gaseous combination. And this law, according to this law, when the gases combines at constant temperature and pressure, what is taking place? Gases combines, right? At constant temperature and pressure. First keyword is the gas. What is combining? Gas. Which condition? Temperature and pressure. Then what is the law say? Gases combines in the simple ratio of their volume. Gases combines in the simple ratio of their volume. Gas combines in the simple ratio of their volume. Example. See, I am reacting nitrogen with hydrogen to form ammonia. This is the very primitive reaction, very simple reaction, which every student know. Here you can see nitrogen gas. And if you relate it with the volume, one volume, three volume, two volume. So what you can see? The nitrogen and hydrogen combines in the ratio of 1:3. So, to form ammonia, we have to mix nitrogen and hydrogen into 1:3 ratio to their volume. Is it that clear? So, the keyword is that you have to react gases at constant temperature and pressure, then you will see gases combines in the simple ratio of their volume. So this is how I concluded the first lecture for this chapter, right? Then I discussed measurement units. So here, sir, you can say,
sir, Someone is asking to repeat the law of definite proportion.
Okay. Definite proportion. I am just passing. Okay, friend. Again, listen. Law of definite proportion. You have to focus on two element. Right? Two element combines together to form at least two or more than two compound. The first thumbing point is that you must keep in your mind only two elements. So when you are taking only two elements, then when you are fixing the mass of one element, Vijay, I am telling, please listen it, Mr. Vijay Singhal. When the fixed mass of an element combines with variable masses of other element, then these variable masses bear the simple ratio of numbers. Again I am repeating. I am taking another example. Suppose I am combining sulfur, one element, with oxygen, another element. These two elements combines together to form at least two compounds. You may get more than two compounds. but at least two compound. Here I am taking only two for your simplicity. Sulfur dioxide and sulfur trioxide. Okay, friend? Now you can see the mass of sulfur is fixed, that is 32. But mass of oxygen is variable, 32 and 48. These are the variable mass. And variable mass, you can see the ratio, 32 is to 48, that is 2 is to 3. So what I can conclude here? How the law of multiple proportion concluded here? The fixed mass of sulfur combines with variable mass of oxygen to form sulfur dioxide and sulfur trioxide, where the mass ratio of mass of oxygen is 2 is to 3. This is the multiple proportion, because the mass of oxygen multiplied with the fixed mass of sulfur. Okay? Rest topic I had discussed earlier, but today I am going to start something new for you. But before going to that, I would like to ask some question. Simple one. There are some properties. I am mentioning some properties for you. Can you write their unit, please? Properties like length, mass, time, temperature. You have to write their unit. I'm waiting for your answer. Okay, I think it is simple one, and everyone is getting the correct answer. How the response is coming? Let me see.
Length coming.
Very good.
Mass ka gram.
Length. The unit of length is?
Meter.
Meter. Very good. Next. The unit of mass is kilogram. The unit of time is?
Second.
Second. And unit of temperature?
Kelvin.
You can convert Kelvin into degree Celsius, degree Fahrenheit. For that I have written formula. You can see my earlier videos. And can you relate one thing more? One picometer will be how many meters? One picometer is how many meters? One picometer is how many meters? Anyone? Anyone who is going to answer this question? One picometer is how many meters? Come on. I answer?
Abhi tak to nahi hai.
10 to power minus 12.
Likha nahi hai abhi tak kisi ne.
One picometer is equal to 10 to power minus 12 meter. Again, I am asking very simple. Can you write 1 picometer is how many centimeter? This is very crucial answer. I am waiting for your answer. Come on. One picometer is 10 to power minus 12 meter. Then 1 picometer is how many centimeter? Vinayak, your answer is correct. I am waiting for centimeter. वेरी गुड। One picometer is 10 to the power minus 10 centimeter. Earlier I discussed all these conversion units. Please, you just visit the first video posted on this site and you will find all these conversion formula. Today I am going to start uncertainty in measurement. Today's topic is uncertainty in measurement. Uncertainty in measurement. Friend, not just chemistry, not but physics, but whenever you are dealing with various subjects which involves measurement, then being the student of science, we have to very fair, we have to very honest. In chemistry it become very important, because in case of chemistry we have to measure very minute units. You are going to deal with atoms which is not visible to your eyes, molecules, compounds, ions, proton, electron, neutrons. These all are the world of chemistry, where you can see how we will play in coming days. Without observing, without seeing anything, you have to build our world. So there may be lots of possibility that you may do some error in your measurement, your observation. Being a student, being researcher, being scientist, you have to try, and we are trying every time that we should get close and closer enough to our real value. But you cannot rule out the possibility of errors. When there is a possibility of error in the measurement, then you can say uncertainty is the one of the key point. So before going to all these things, let me play some, you can say game for you. Can you read out please this number? I know. Not easy to read it out. Since we can go up to million, billion, etc. and etc. Similarly, can you count this number?
Point thoda bada kar de.
So these are the such a number. You cannot say this is vague one. These are the very important number. But when you will write all these number to your copy, then it will acquire lots of space, and moreover it is not easy to understand. So whenever you are getting such data, like in case of distance of Earth from Sun, astronomical unit. Similarly, corona is making havoc throughout the world, you know. Can you tell me how long coronavirus is? Anyone? Can you see? Corona is in the terms of angstrom, nanometer, picometer, not more than that. And this minuscule molecule, I can say, microorganism, that is virus, is taking entire community of the world to their toe. But who will measure the length of the coronavirus? It is you people in future. And like you, many more are measuring it throughout the world. And I can write many more zero to measure the length of corona. But it is not the way by which we are representing. Now, this is the decimal count. Count with 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And this is the 13th place. So I can write it like 10 to power minus 13th place. After decimal, how many digits are there? You can write it like using minus. So power minus 13. Similarly, 1, 2, 3, I can count it from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. So I can just write this one like 23. This number is very popular number. And I can say it is lifeline for chemistry, Avogadro number. So when you are dealing with large data, you can express it into scientific term, and these are the scientific term. When you are measuring anything which is very small, then you have to take the scientific notation. So we can express our data by using scientific notation. So before moving to measurement, before moving to uncertainty, you have to write the scientific notation. Scientific notation. 1 into 10 to power minus 6. 2 into 10 to power minus 7. 3 into 10 to power 8 meter per second. This is the speed of light. 6.023 into 10 to power 23. This is Avogadro number. So smaller number, bigger number. Experimental data. Smaller number, bigger number, experimental data. You can write all these by using scientific notation. So these are the scientific notation. Right? Then how I can add, multiply, divide? That means basic mathematical operation for data expressed for scientific notation. Basic mathematical operation. First addition. Example. Can you add it 1 into 10 to power minus 7 plus 1 into 10 to power minus 9? 1 into 10 to power minus 7 plus 1 into 10 to power minus 9. So this is the new thing for you people. 1, 1. No way. So you have to take common value. 10 to power minus 7 is common. Right? Then it becomes 1. 10 to power 1 is not going to make any significant change. So 10 to power minus 7, then you will find 1 plus 10 to power minus 2. Right? So you have to take the common value when you are adding the things together. Since when you are adding 1 plus 10 to power minus 2, I can write 10 to power minus 2 like this one. 10 to power minus 2 like this one. It is easily handled. So my answer is 1.01 into 10 to power minus 7. That is how you can get the total sum of these two values. 1 into 10 to power minus 7 plus 1 into 10 to power minus 9. Learn it. How can I add the things together? You have take. Bilkul. Correct one. Not like that. It is not here. You are not adding power. What I am doing, please follow it. You are adding two values. Pramita Moitra, you are multiplying it, not adding it. So rule of addition is something different. Rule of addition is something different. Let me take another example. I can start it by using some simple value, even manageable value, you can say. You can add 10 to power 3 plus 10 to power 5. Then what is the value? Come on. Ten to power 3 plus 10 to power 5. I am waiting for your answer. Three and 10 to power 5, not minus. 10 to power 3 plus 10 to power 5. First, since this data is manageable, I am just breaking it in down. 10 to power minus 3 means 1000. And 10 to power minus 3 means?
10 to the power 5.
Right? 10 to power 5 means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 lakhs, you can say. So, by using 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. You can write and get the answer like this. This is the simple mathematics. But here what I can do? I can take the common value from these two. And the 10 to power 3 is common. Then it becomes 1. And it becomes 10 to power 2. Division and multiplication. Just divide it. For division, I can write 10 to power 3 and 10 to power 5. For division, since I am using here, I am just telling it you in advance. 10 to power 5 and 10 to power 3. Base is same, then you can apply the rule of power you know. 5 minus 3 becomes 10 to power 2. Base 10 is same, then you just subtract power together. 5 minus 3. And what you can get? 10 to power 3 into 100 plus 1, that is 101. Now you can also simplify 1.01 into 10 to power 1.01 into 10 power 5. Clear? Okay. Similarly, you can do the subtraction by taking the common power. You just can do the subtraction. Nothing to worry about it. Just like addition, what you have to do? Suppose I am just subtracting 10 to power minus 10 to power 3. Again, you have to take the common value 10 to power 3. Then it becomes 100 minus 1, 90, 9 into 10 to power 3, 9.9 into 10 to power 4. Is it that clear? Is it that clear? Hello friends, are you getting the correct answer? Okay. So, by taking the common factor, you can add and subtract your value. This is going to be trademark calculation in chemistry. And next, multiplication. Multiplication. Okay. 10 to power minus 3 into 10 to power minus 2. When you are multiplying the things, see the base is common. And when you are multiplying, then power becomes total. So minus 3 plus minus 2, 10 to power minus 5. Is it that clear? When you are adding powers, then take the common base and powers added together. And for subtraction, division, just make it reverse. 10 to power minus 3 divided by 10 to power minus 5. Then what you will see? Base is same. 10 to power minus 3 and minus of minus 5. I am here using minus. When you are subtracting, then it becomes negative. And when you are adding, multiplying, then it becomes addition. So, minus half minus become plus minus 3 plus 5 will give 10 to power 2. Is it that clear? That is how you can do your basic calculation in chemistry. This is very important one and you have to keep it in your mind continuously. I am giving some question to you. Meanwhile, I am taking another concept. Before going to the other one, you just solve some question. First,
थोड़ा बड़ा कर दीजिए, कैमरे में कम दिखाई दे रहा है, रेड से डार्क।
चलो मैं पॉइंट को रेड से कर देता हूँ।
अब सही। फोर पॉइंट टू है।
So first one is 1.25 into 10 to power minus 3 plus 3.75 into 10 to power minus 3. You have to add this together. Second one is 4.2 into 10 to power minus 5 into 2 into 10 to power minus 7. third one is 9.1 into 10 to power minus 3 plus 9.1 into 10 to power minus 5, and fourth one is 3.7 into 10 to power minus 5 divided by 1 into 10 to power minus 7. I am waiting for your answer.
पहले का बच्चा भेज रहा काफी 5 into 10 to the power minus 3.
करेक्ट, फर्स्ट वन इज करेक्ट, 5 into 10 to power minus 3. दिस इज वेरी गुड.
सेकेंड का है 8.4 into 10 to the power minus 12.
Very good. 8.4 into 10 power minus 12. That is correct one.
Third का भेज रहे हैं 9.1 into 10 to the power minus 2.
Minus 2.
और देखते हैं और भेजेंगे, अभी तो एक नहीं भेजा. फोर्थ का 3.7 into 10 to the power minus 12. फोर्थ का 3.7 into 10 to the power minus 12.
माइनस 12 नहीं, for first one your answer is absolutely correct since you are adding, so take this common factor 10 to power minus 3 and add these two value, then you will find 5 into 10 to power minus 3. So the first one is correct. Similarly second one, it is simply a multiplication, 4.2 into 2 that is 8.4 and power added together, that means 10 to power minus 2. Again it is correct. This time you have to subtract and common value is what? 9.1. Then what you will find? 10 to power minus 3 and 10 to power minus 5. Again you can take the value. 9.1 into 10 to power minus 3, 1 minus 10 to power minus 2. And what you will see? That this one is 1.1 minus 0.01, that means 0.99. So here 0.99 into 10 to power minus 3 and then 9.1. Now you can multiply all these values together. 0.99, almost it is close to 1, but you have to get the correct value. So this one two together, then 10 power minus 3. Right? So check it in correct way. Next one is a simple one. Division is there, so 3.7 into 10 to power, this become power. This minus 7 become plus 7. That means minus 5 divided by minus 7. So you will find 3.7 into 10 to power 2. Minus become plus. When you are taking it from denominator to numerator, the sign become opposite. Okay. Today's last point is total, because I am talking about uncertainty. That is very important term, again I am saying. So for uncertainty, two terms become very very common one, very very important one. Before moving to next topic, I would like to introduce these two terms. One is accuracy and other is precision. Anyone who wants to define accuracy and precision, please respond your answer. Accuracy and precision, two terms. Please do write your answers. What is precision? What is accuracy? Precision. Okay, someone is writing. Moitra. Precision is an appropriate answer. Okay. Sunil Daya. Precision is the closeness of various measurement. Correct one. Okay. Accuracy is the correct one. So many more students are writing the correct answer. Those who are writing it correct, I just congratulate all of you. So precision is the closeness of various measurement of the same quantity. Precision is the closeness of various measurements of the same quantity. I am going to take example to explain what is the precision and what is accuracy. And the accuracy is the agreement of particular value to the true value of result. Right? Again, accuracy is the agreement of a particular value to the true value of result. True value of result is already reported to you, and you have to measure the quantity. And if you are accurate, then your value is matching with the true value. So we are generally using all these terms in our life. Be precise, be accurate. Right? Be precise, be accurate. I am taking one example. Can you tell me, although it is not very easy to answer, but you can try it. what would be the length of this pen? What would be the length of this pen? You might have seen marker in your classroom with your teacher, anyway, anywhere. Can you suggest the value of length of this marker? Just I am holding it for you. See, I am writing true value. True value is 13.5 centimeter. Since you are just guessing the length, it might be that value or something here and there. The true value is 13.7. So someone is giving answer 13 centimeter, someone is 15 centimeter, someone is 9 centimeter, right? Someone is 10 centimeter. So since you are just guessing, so there is no way to write, I mean, ask it, no way to say that your answer is correct or incorrect or wrong or right. Because you are guessing, so your guess can be anything. So, how can you say your measurement is accurate or precise? Who is saying that his value is accurate? And who is saying that his value is precise? Okay friend, let me discuss the value for you. Suppose we have 3 students with more than 3 measurement or 2 measurement. You can take student A, student B, student C. Student 1 have 2 measurement. And if he is writing that it is 12 and another is 13, next one is writing it 12.2 and 12.3. And next one is writing 13.4 and 13.6. These three students is measuring the value. The measurement made by student is neither precise nor accurate. Neither precise nor accurate. But you can see student B, what he measured it is precise one because its value is very close agreement with each other. Student C, you can say his values both precise and accurate. Because by getting average, you will get true value. So the most important thing is that you will see in your chemistry lab, when you will visit after lockdown period, you have to perform various experiments, like very popular experiment is the volumetric analysis. In the volumetric analysis, we have to take the measurement of volume which is consumed for the titration of acid or base or something oxidizing and reducing agent. So those student who getting constant continuously same data or very closer same data, then you can say he is getting precise and accurate value. And there may be some student who is getting some value, another value is which is quite different to each other. So when your measurement is very close to each other, then you can say your measurement is precise. And when it is going to be close to the true value, then you can say it is accurate one. Very good. So this is again scientific practice which you have to take whenever you are taking the reading or whenever you are taking the experimental data for you. As we are nearing to our session, I would like to give you some question to answer. And for today, what I have studied, what I have discussed with you, the uncertainty in measurement and how can you operate big and small scientific data with using scientific notation. And while you are measuring the value in laboratory, how can you get your observation accurate and precise? So for today's exercise, again for recapitulation, first question is just write definition of matter so that you can revise it properly. Atom, homogeneous mixture, randomly I am giving you. And element, second is define and state and define, you define the law of multiple proportion. You just write all these in your copy, multiple proportion, as it will be checked by your teacher with example. Number 3, convert 1 nanometer into 1, 2, 3, 4 millimeter, centimeter, meter, kilometer. Number 4, क्वेश्चन नंबर फोर, राइट द फार्मूला ऑफ कंपाउंड्स फॉर्म्ड बाय कैल्शियम आयन एंड क्लोराइड सल्फेट फॉस्फेट एंड आल्सो कैलकुलेट देयर मॉलिकुलर वेट। फिफ्थ क्वेश्चन, फिफ्थ क्वेश्चन, कैलकुलेट द फॉलोइंग। फर्स्ट 6.023 इंटू 10 पावर माइनस 23 इंटू 10 टू पावर माइनस 3। सेकेंड 8 इंटू 10 टू पावर माइनस 3 सब्सट्रैक्टेड टू 2 इंटू 10 टू पावर माइनस 4। थर्ड वन 2.2 इंटू 10 टू पावर माइनस 5 डिवाइडेड बाय 1.1 इंटू 10 टू पावर माइनस 7 माइनस 9। एंड फोर्थ इज 1.01 इंटू 10 टू पावर 2 प्लस 0.1 इंटू 10 टू पावर 3। सो ऑल दीज फाइव क्वेश्चन यू हैव टू राइट इन योर कॉपी एंड इट मस्ट बी चेक बाय योर टीचर, राइट? द फिफ्थ वन रिक्वायरमेंट कैलकुलेशन एंड फोर्थ वन यू हैव टू राइट द फॉर्मूला बाय यूजिंग 1 कैटायन कैल्शियम एंड एनायन क्लोराइड सल्फेट फॉस्फेट एंड ऑल्सो कैलकुलेट देयर मोलर मास। Tomorrow I will take significant figure and mole concept. But today I am signing it off. Thank you very much.